I'm a civilian. I'm actually in this faculty, so it's very nice to be here. So I represent, together with Maria here and Ludmila, we represent the Human Rights House Foundation, which is the secretariat of Human Rights House Network. And this is a network with more than 80 organizations in 15 countries. And we work to protect and empower and support human rights organizations locally and unite them together in a human rights house network. Right to freedom of expression, assembly, association, and the right to be a human rights defender, because we think these are the main rights you need to have to really do the work to protect human rights and to be engaged and to develop a democratic society. We have this week 10 with us today, 10 prominent human rights defenders from the countries Mariam already mentioned, and we are here in Oslo to meet with the Ministry of Foreign Affairs, with people from the parliament, from media representatives, and to make sure that they know about the situation in these countries, in Eastern Europe, and know about the challenges for human rights defenders there, and also to give them some recommendations, what they can do to support human rights defenders.
Я буду говорить по-русски.
I will be speaking in Russian.
Меня зовут Жанна Литвина.
My name is Жанна Литвина.
Я председатель Белорусской ассоциации журналистов.
I'm a chairperson of the Belarusian Association of Journalists.
У нас в Беларуси две организации писателей, две журналистские организации.
In Belarus we have two organizations for journalists and two organizations for writers.
И я как раз представляю эту организацию, но и тех журналистов, которых Лукашенко, наш президент, называет нечестными.
And I represent those journalists whom Lukashenko consider as not fair.
То есть есть честные, которые работают в его государственных СМИ, и есть нечестные. Это журналисты из независимых СМИ, это журналисты, которые работают с интернет-ресурсами.
So we have those journalists that who are fair journalists, according to Lukashenko, who are pro-governmental mass media, and we also have those who are not fair, and who work with independent media.
Нам почти 20 лет. В организации 1200 членов организации.
We are almost 20 years old now, and we have 1,200 members in our organization.
Мы занимаемся юридической защитой журналистов, образовательными программами, издаем журнал, ведем мониторинг.
We give support to our journalists, educate them, and also publish journals and so on.
Если будут вопросы, я на них отвечу.
And if you have any questions, please ask them.
And then we have also Anna from Belarus.
Hi, my name is Anna. I'm living in Lithuania, Belarus, where I'm living in the Belarusian Human Rights House, which operates in exile in Lithuania.
Then I have Lara.
Okay, I'll sit if it's okay with you. My name is Lara Aharonian. I'm from Yerevan, Armenia. I'm one of the founders of the Women's Resource Center. I'm a woman human rights defender and a feminist activist working on women's rights in my country, violence against women, and engaging women in peace initiatives.
Thank you.
My name is Anna Dobrovolska. I'm coming from Russia, from Voronezh. I'm chairperson of the Human Rights House back at home, and I'm also a member of International Youth Human Rights Movement.
Hello, I'm Tatiana Kuchuch. I'm from Ukraine, Kyiv. I represent Human Rights House Kyiv and Human Rights Information Center. I will be talking later, so I will not take your time now.
Hello everyone, my name is Shahla Ismail. I'm the chairperson of Women's Association for Rational Development. At the same time, I'm an editor and director in the Human Rights House in Azerbaijan.
Я тоже нечестный журналист, журнала тоже.
I'm also a conquered journalist from a journal called DOSH from Chechnya.
Можете сидеть?
Можете, да.
Меня зовут Инна, я из Чечни, женский ресурсный центр Синтем, координатор программного отдела.
My name is Inna. I am from Chechnya as well, and I work with Human Resource and Women's Resource Center.
Меня зовут Абдулла, я тоже из журнала ДОЖ, Россия, Чечня.
My name is Abdulla, I'm also from the journal DOSH, who you will all find over there, both in Russian and English, those of you who are interested, from Czech as well.
So all these people, they represent different organizations, and they are members of human rights houses in their countries. We also, as you can see, we have some t-shirts, some of us have t-shirts. And these are people who could have been together with us, but they are not able because they are in prison. So I have Leyla Yunus, she's a human rights defender from Azerbaijan. You can see here with Tanya, she has Rasul Jafarov, another one. And then Ludmila there, she has a lawyer from Azerbaijan. So they are people we love to have here, but they are not able to come because of that. So that's why we present them in this way.
So we'll start with Tatiana Kuchanchuk from Ukraine. She will tell some about her work and what they do. How they do it and what are the challenges when they do it. So then we'll move on to Anna.
Hello.
And then I will refer to Inna and Abdullah from Chechnya.
As I mentioned, I'm from Kiev, and in my student's time I was active when there was a head of the student parliament in our institute. So I was responsible for defending students' rights in the university, and that is why later I became a journalist and human rights defender since that time. And by the way, as a student leader, I was here in Oslo 10 years ago. It's interesting that I'm here one more time. I want to tell you just several things about the involvement of students and youth to the events in Ukraine, and I would be glad to answer your questions. Maybe I think that all of you heard about the Euromaidan revolution that happened in Ukraine in winter, so almost a year ago. And it's interesting that at the beginning of this revolution, like many other in many other countries, it was students and youth who started this protest. In November 2013, when our ex-president Yanukovych decided not to sign the EU association agreement with the European Union, people started to protest and to go to the street, to the main street of Kyiv, Khreshchatyk, and to Maidan Nezalezhnosti, Independence Square. A lot of them were young people and students, so they stood and protested like a week, peacefully protested, and then on November 30, police and the special police department called Berkut severely beaten these students who were during the night, they stood all the time on Maidan, and during the night they made a campus protesting against the policy of Ukraine and policy of ex-president that moved it to custom union in Russia. So after it was the beginning of the revolution, because on the next day hundreds of thousands of people went to the street, to the main square of Kyiv, Independence Square, to protest against this police brutality. And it is interesting that at the beginning the protest was only pro-European, and when police severely beaten these students and the young people, protesters, the revolution started to be a revolution for the human dignity and human rights and against police brutality, against corruption and a lot of problems that were in Ukraine many years. So after that, When the revolution started, young people were actively participating in this event, and I want to tell you especially about one very interesting initiative, Euromaidan SOS, that I was also part of it. It is a group of young people, students, young professionals who were working or who were studying in the universities, who tried to help the victims that were repressed by the current government. And these people united and worked as a hotline, collected the information about human rights abuses, trying to provide the help to the victims, to provide the documentation of human rights abuses, and to find the lawyers who provide free legal support to people who were persecuted by police and by court system. And to also they organized psychological help to those who were persecuted. And many others, and now as we see